I'm Mask Corporal Alex Alder from Langley, BC, and I'm a signals technician.
In a landscape of ever-changing technology, signal technicians play a vital role in keeping communications flowing in the Canadian Armed Forces.
Fire!
When I tell my friends what my job description is, I like to tell them that I'm a jack-of-all-trades repairman. Whether it be antennas, radios, headsets, satellites, as long as it transmits or receives, I fix it.
On a day-to-day basis, signal technicians take care of equipment maintenance, service telephone systems, and communication information systems, and ensure network security on bases across Canada. They are responsible for all tactical communications equipment, linking soldiers, vehicles, and commanders in headquarters and in the field. They also work on IT-related tasks such as cable installations and repairs, analyzing faulty equipment, or performing technical inspections for IT security.
You're still a member of the military and you're still expected to be a soldier first. So you get a bit of both worlds. You still get to sleep in the tent, shoot guns, and do a lot of the cool army stuff. But at the same time, you're really using your brain and getting into electronics and fixing them. It's a good mix. It lets you do what you want to do, but also do the army thing.
Signal technicians are responsible for configuring, maintaining, and securing communication networks and systems on behalf of the Canadian Armed Forces wherever they operate. They can work closely with information systems technicians, line technicians, cyber operators, and, depending on where they're posted, with the combat arms. As their careers develop, technicians will also be called upon to instruct, lead, supervise, and manage subordinates, as well as plan and advise commanders with the employment and deployment of these platforms and systems, all while managing the life cycle of the communications equipment.
The job of a signal technician is critical to every unit you're a part of. You are the person responsible for fixing, maintaining, and upkeeping all the communications equipment across the entire unit. Sometimes that can involve hundreds of vehicles and hundreds of headsets and hundreds of radios. And so without a signal technician, those things wouldn't be possible. So we are a very important part of any unit in the military. The best part of the job for me is when I get given a problem where the person doesn't know what's wrong and it's not something that's in the books, where I can't just flip to a manual page and see X is causing Y, so I need to do Z. I like thinking outside the box, fixing things that don't have instructions on how to fix them. And it's that extra challenge of having to figure something out without having been taught it that makes being a signals tech so gratifying to me.
To maintain their highly adaptive skill set, signal technicians can expect to travel often throughout the year, participating in exercises and training courses. They may also have the opportunity to work with unmanned aircraft systems.
In 2020, I was deployed on Op Impact to Taji, Iraq. I was almost relied upon solely to do anything communications related, not even in my line of work. People would come to me with cell phones, people would come to me with equipment I haven't even seen before, but it's expected that I can open this up, diagnose the issue, and repair it. And that sort of thing ties back into the challenges that I look for when I do this job. I often receive quite a lot of gratitude from the people that I help when I fix their equipment for them. And that kind of gratitude really strengthens the love for my job, knowing that what I do makes a visible impact for the people around me and helps them do their job better.